In this video, you will get to know how to reach Kodaikanal by air, by bus and by train. I will also inform you how to find and book best car rental services if you are planning to reach Kodaikanal by renting a cab. And I will also provide current market rates of car rental services. I will also give you a step-by-step guidance and tips which one should always keep in mind before hiring any car rental services. And these tips will also help you in the future. I will also tell you about some of the best routes to reach Kodaikanal by road from Chennai, Bangalore, Kochi and Trivandrum, which will make your road trip more amazing and thrilling. In the end, you will also get to know about some off-road trails to reach Kodaikanal by bike and by car for adventure lovers. So stay with me till the end. There are different travel options to reach Kodaikanal, that is via air or via road or via train. The airport nearest to Kodaikanal is Madurai International Airport, about 120 kilometers away. Others in the line include the Trichy Airport and the Coimbatore Airport, 150 kilometers and 175 kilometers away respectively. You can also land in Chennai or Bangalore Airport, which are well connected to other metros and major cities in India, and also operates a number of international flights to all major cities of the world. From the airport, you can easily get a bus or cab to Kodaikanal. Well, you can also rent a bike. The distance from Chennai to Kodaikanal is 525 kilometers and from Bangalore to Kodaikanal is 464 kilometers. The nearest railway station to Kodaikanal are Kodai Road and Palani. You will easily get trains from Chennai, Bangalore and Kochi or other nearby places to reach Palani and Kodai Road railway station. You can check the timings and schedule on IRCTC app or website. Other railway stations are Dindigul Junction, Madurai Junction, Chennai Railway Station and Bangalore Railway Station. These are well connected with all the major cities in India. Kodai Road is approximately 100 kilometers away from the main city, whereas Palani Railway Station is approximately 65 kilometers away. From Kodai Road and Palani Railway Station, you can get a taxi or cab to reach Kodaikanal. Being the only mode of transportation, taxi rates are high, not all that negotiable. You also have the options to book cabs or taxi online. It will cost you around Rs 1500 to Rs 2000. From Kodai Road, you can also rent bullets or gearless bikes and ride to Kodaikanal Hill, one of the cheap and the best way to enjoy the stay. If you are coming to Palani Railway Station, then I will suggest travelers to stop here for a while to enjoy and explore the beautiful scenic beauty and the local sightseeing of Palani. In the road trip by cab from Palani or Kodai Road to Kodaikanal will give you an amazing experience of traveling through ghats, mountains and valleys. But you will enjoy the journey more if you are coming from Palani as compared to Kodai Road. Regular bus services are available from the cities of Chennai, Pondicherry, Bangalore, Kochi, Ooty and many more. You can use Redbus app or website to book tickets or to check the schedule and availability. Coming by bus is the best and efficient way to save money. You can also rent or book a cab or self-drive from different places like Chennai, Bangalore or Kochi and many more nearby places to reach Kodaikanal. Renting a cab will cost you around 10 to 13 rupees per kilometer. If you want a round trip by cab that is going to Kodaikanal and then returning back, you can also use Ola app. There are also lots of taxi and cab services available offline and online. You can find some offline car rental services near market or main railway station or bus stand, or you can just Google it. Else, for more services you can check in Just Dial app or website. Just search cabs for Kodaikanal and you will find plenty of options. You can call them personally one by one by seeing their ratings and review, and then you can choose the appropriate one who provides you best price and service. Before renting any cab or taxi, it is important to check whether their service include toll tax and all the permits on the way. First of all, let me give you the idea of estimate fare of cab services. So mini will cost you around 9 rupees per kilometer. Prime sedan will cost you 10 rupees per kilometer. Prime SUV will cost you 13 to 13.5 rupees per kilometer. And a big SUV will cost you 17 rupees per kilometer. Now, as you have got a little idea of the cab fare, the second step is to check whether or not your service provider is providing you cab in the rates which I have mentioned just now. If he is providing cab for higher rates, then please inform them that these are the market rates and try to bargain by saying I will not give you a single penny above it. And if they still disagree, then just look for another service provider. Do not listen to them or don't get into their words, as they will try to confuse you by telling different stories. Directly say no and start looking for the another one. After finding a trusted service provider who is providing cabs in the market rates, then the next step is to ask them whether the package or journey include all the toll tax, state tax and other permits required for the journey. Then most of them will tell you on the way there will be this number of toll tax, and they will calculate the price of each toll tax on the way and will tell you an estimated amount with tax. Then they will ask you either you pay the amount to us and our driver will take care of the rest and he will pay all the toll tax on the way and any other permit required, or else instead of giving that amount to us you can keep the amount with you and pay all the toll tax by yourself. Now which option you choose, it totally depends on you, but in my case I prefer to pay by my own instead of giving money to the service provider. Okay, so let me tell you why it is important to ask your service provider about the toll tax and the state permits. It is important because maximum service provider will charge you for distance between the journey by charging you per kilometer, and then they will separately calculate the estimated amount of toll tax, permit and other services required for the journey and will give you an estimated bill, which means that now your package covers all the toll tax, permit and other services on the way. But while booking, most of the time a new person do not check all these things or do not understand or doesn't have the knowledge that he has to verify all these things before going for a journey. And then it should not happen that on the way the driver is asking you to pay the toll tax or any other entry permit charges in between the journey, which your package already include, which you have already paid in the package, and the driver will try to confuse you. And later, due to the trip excitement, most of them do not even pay attention to this. And so there are a lot of chances that you forgot all these things and end up paying the extra amount for the toll tax or any other permits or services, which you have already paid, which means you got scammed and you did not even realize that you got scammed. If you are coming by cab, your journey will totally depend on the driver. So try to get a driver with higher ratings if booking online. It is better to call or talk with the service provider before starting the journey. Tell them to provide you the good driver who can understand your language, who is calm and polite and should follow your instructions and should stop wherever you want to stop and should take you to the place wherever you want to go. Before starting the journey, I will suggest you to take a peek of the driver and the car number plate in front of the driver to show him that your trip is being tracked by someone and they doesn't have any chance to think to do something wrong. If possible, take a peek of his Aadhaar card or driving license. If you are coming by car from Chennai to Kodaikanal, the journey is little bit long and boring. On the way, you can pay a short visit to Mahabalipuram and Pondicherry. The ride from Mahabalipuram till Pondicherry will be a memorable experience and amazing road trip. The main journey of beautiful zigzag uphill road will start after Dindigul. But instead of taking the regular road while coming from Chennai, try to enter Kodaikanal via Palani to make the journey more exciting. If you are coming via Palani, you can stop there to enjoy the scenic beauty of the Palani Hills. I will suggest you from Chennai enter Kodaikanal from Palani and while returning back to Chennai go via regular route. If you want to explore more, you can also visit Munnar. And again, if you feel like visiting some more new places, go towards Uti. From Bangalore, there are two routes to reach Kodaikanal. You can either come via Hosur, Sellam, Namakkal, Dindigul or via Madhuru, Somnathapura, Tripur, Palani to Kodaikanal. It depends on you which route you will prefer. Though I will suggest you to come via Madhuru, Palani to Kodaikanal, which will be an amazing road trip. You also have the option to visit Uti and while returning from Kodaikanal, take the other route via Dindigul, Hosur to Bangalore. If you want to explore more, you can also visit Munnar. Driving from Kochi to Kodaikanal is one of the best road trips. There are two routes to come from Kochi to Kodaikanal. One is via Thrissur, Palakkad and Palani. On the way you can visit various tourist places and hill stations. Another route is from Muvattupuzha, Kothamangalam, Adimali, Munnar, Devikulam, Theni, Periyakulam to Kodaikanal. On the way you can visit Munnar and many other tourist places. Both the routes are wonderful. Visit Kodaikanal via one route and return from Kodaikanal via another route. That will be the best option. From Trivandrum, there are three routes to reach Kodaikanal. But I will suggest you two routes. One is via Kalimanur, Pathanam Titha, Kumili, Theni, Batlagundu to Kodaikanal. And the another one is from Tenmala, Rajapalyam, Maharajapuram, Batlagundu to Kodaikanal. The route from Kerala to Kodaikanal are the best. Try to include both the routes in your trip. If you are coming from Dindigul, come via Palani instead of coming from the regular route. If you want to experience incredible road trip, drive from Kodaikanal to Munnar. Avoid driving at night times. It is a warning. I have the habit to drive at night and I have faced many problems. I have shared some experience in my Munnar travel guide episodes. If you are coming by bike, then there is a 49 km shortcut road from Periyakulam to Kodaikanal via Kumbakarai and Adukkum to Kodaikanal. And there are some other routes, that is via Palani Hills, Northern Slope Hills, Perumparai, Thandikundi, Panaikadu, Perumal Malai to Kodaikanal. And one is via Adalur, Perumparai, Thandikudi, Perumal Malai to Kodaikanal. You can cover this journey if you are coming from Dindigul, Kodai Road or Madurai to Kodaikanal, which can be a thrilling road trip by bike. I insist you to select this route under any expert guidance, that is most probably from the locals. If you are coming alone, avoid this route. And before taking this route, do a proper inquiry, ask local about the exact way via these places. You can also drive by car if you are an expert driver. Do ask locals about the road condition before taking this step.